Welcome on NeeTV. In this tutorial, I will show you how to make a full hair with ZBrush and Substance Painter or not. So let's go. It's for Character Creator 3. We're gonna work with my character, this one. One of my creation. And we will try to make some quick hair. So for this, let's go load ZBrush and let's start. So the first thing we need to do is to choose a position. So I will choose the T-pose position, so this one. I will first, I will make the hair, okay? So let's do it. I will not show you a full making of hair, but just a small part of it. And after, you can do what you want yourself. So first thing you need to do is to cover the skull with the mask, but not all the skull, only a part of the skull. For this one, we're gonna make the rear of the skull. So I make symmetry on, and I mask the area I want to make hair. This one. Now we're gonna go inside here, fiber mesh. And lightbox fiber. We're gonna choose fiber 160, this one, and close the lightbox here. Go to modification, and the first thing we need to do is to change the length of the hair. So we're gonna reduce the length. Like this seems nice, maybe more shorter. Like this, we're gonna zoom in. Okay, it seems nice. Now we're gonna check two things. First, the base size at 1 and the end size at 0.0, etc. But you need to have 0.0. It's nice, it's good. This is the... Here you can see the curl of the hair. I will let this like this. The gravity, okay, and the segment. The segment is the articulation of the hair. More segment you have, more your hair can move easily. So I will change it to maybe 17, okay, and I let it like this. So now we're gonna go inside the cover right here, just under the length, and we're gonna choose 5000, the maximum, like this one. And now what I want is to reduce the number of the hair. So it's here, maximum fiber, and I choose maybe less. 1.0. I will choose maybe 0.5, like this. Okay, I keep 0.5. And for me, that is all. So I'm gonna click on accept, and this is gonna create me a fiber. I work only on a copy for safety, so duplicate and fiber 10 become fiber 11. And now I'm gonna use a quick brush on it. So go to your brush and I will choose gloom air toss. Yes, seems nice. So let's try it. It's not nice. I'm on the side view, I make a bigger brush and I move it like this. I give the air a small. As you can see, this is not good because all the air are in the same position, so that's not good. So go back, Ctrl Z, Ctrl Z, Ctrl Z, Ctrl Z, Ctrl Z, and I think I will let the air like if there was. You can move the air like you want, but honestly, the best way to move the air is not using an airbrush, is simply using the move brush. The move brush, for me, is better than the airbrush, because with the move brush, if you make symmetry on, you can give to the hair a real shape, something very nice than you cannot have with the original airbrush. So I'm gonna just add some volumes here, bigger brush, and I'm gonna make the hair more nearest of the skin, like this. I'm gonna reduce the hair here. Again, we're gonna keep this one. So now it's time to make the hair. We got 18,000 poly. You can have less poly, but you cannot use remesher. You need to remake a new fiber mesh and reduce the number of fiber. So I'm gonna keep this. I'm gonna call it rear one. Okay. And now I'm gonna make UV. If you want to have UV on your hair cards like this, you do not go inside the UV master, because it's gonna destroy it. You need to go inside here, coordinate texture. Okay, we are in 2K, and go to create UV fiber. That's all. Now you get UV on it. And now what we're gonna do, we are in rear one, we're gonna export this in OBJ. So let's go rear one point OBJ, save it. That's all. Now, the part 2 of this video, we're gonna make the hair texture. So for this, what I need to do is to hide the hair. I need to zoom out. I need to add an item. So click here, add, and I want a 3D plane like this. Now I need to add to hide my character and just have my 3D plane like this one. Check the firmware. Okay, seems good. Click on center. Choose the skin shade material like this. And now we're gonna use the mask. So I use symmetry. I make a bigger brush size and I just mask a part, the upper part of this, like this. And I go again inside the fiber mesh here, and lightbox fiber 160, close the lightbox clicking on it, and I got this. Okay. And now we're gonna make some modification. So what we need to do is to change the length. Maybe it's too short. This one seems nice. The maximum fiber, so I will reduce it like this. Maybe like this. Okay, seems pretty nice. Like this one. I'm gonna check one time with BPR render. Okay, let's zoom in to have more details. BPR seems pretty nice. Maybe I got too much. I got too much air on it. So what I'm gonna do is simply remove the mask and mask the smaller area like this. That's all. I'm gonna go again in Lightbox 160 and close Lightbox. Yes, I think this one is better. So I adjust the maximum fiber like this. I adjust the length. Maybe it's too short. This one seems nice. And the cover. I will add just a little more cover. Make a render on it. It seems pretty nice. I cut the curl. I make 0. It's not very nice, so I keep 180. For me, it seems nice, but I will reduce the maximum fiber to have something more clear, like this. Ah, okay, it seems nice. So I will keep it. For me, it's good, so click on accept. And I got a new fiber mesh. I work on copy, so duplicate it. Now, this time, I will use the move brush. And I will try to give a shape to the hair. Something like this. Okay. You can use the brush. Let me show you with the airbrush. Maybe like Goom Hair Long. With this brush, you can have something. You can have a straight hair. You can move it as you want, like this. Seems pretty nice. Try to make something nice. Okay, I think this one is better, so I will keep this one. So, for this. So, okay, it's good, so I name it Hair Texture. Hair Texture 1. Okay. I will add the 3D plane. We don't need it anymore. I'm on air texture. And now what I'm gonna do is to deselect the Z plus, go to MRVB, choose a material to make the air color. So for make the air color, I will choose maybe something will look like air. What can what air something who looks like air, maybe reflect yellow. Okay, click. Remember, you don't have UV, so go inside coordinate texture, go inside UV fiber, and we got UV. And now go inside fill object 1 time, 2 time, 3 time, 5 time. Seems nice. Click on render. Okay, we got render. Again, render. Seems nice. Go inside render. Go inside property render. And uncheck the shadow. Try again render. Okay, maybe it seems a little too dark. So, fill object again to have something lighter. Render seems nice. I think I'm gonna keep the render like this one. So just for the color, I will go inside render and check again shadow. One render, okay. Go inside render and go inside render PBR. Pass. And what we need, this one, the color one. No, we need, this is not the color we need, this is the shaded we need. Yes, this is this one. Shaded one. So click on it and name it color. This is PNG. Save it. Click here on mask and save it as BMP, and this is call it mask. Save it. And what we're gonna do right now is to change the material and to check, click on normal RGB mat and fill object like this. Go to render, go inside render property, uncheck the shadow, make a render BPR. Okay, go back inside render, go inside render pass and take this one, the shaded one. Yes, this is the shaded one. Click on it. This is a PNG and click on and name it normal and save it. Now go to check directly where you save it, if you got all. As you can see, I got my PNG. This is the air color. This is the mask color and the normal. Okay, now we're gonna resize it because as you can see, this is not 2K. So click, right click on it, modify, it's open, it's just opening paint. So it's perfect. Click on, resize, pixel, uncheck convert proportion and click on 20. Click on 2K, add 2K, it's 2048, and OK, and now file, save. OK, it changed. Now do the same with the mask, right click, modify, open paint, resize, uncheck here, pixel, 2K, 2K. OK, file, save. Ah, this is a BPM, so go back inside modify, go back in file, save as PNG. Mask PNG, save. OK, now you can delete the mask BPM. We need only PNG format. So for the normal, make the same, modify, resize, pixel, uncheck, 2K, 2K, OK, file, save. We got normal. OK, we got all. We got all the three we need. So let's go. We got all. So now you get your texture and we're gonna make a first try. We're gonna do a first try. So go back inside character, Creator 3. Change the pose. I was in T-pose, so I check the T-pose. I go inside create, accessory, choose rear one, open, and it's gonna appear somewhere here. So go to modify, go inside here the pivot, to the center and move it to the place where he need to go, he need to be. So I think this is the good place. Okay, maybe a little more inside like this. Okay, and now we're gonna this is the first method without Substance Painter. So without Substance Painter we are in BPR. Okay, we go inside the field I saved before, so I need to add the color map on color. This is the mask is for the opacity, so I will go inside the opacity, and the normal map inside bump map. And it don't works. It don't works because the opacity is not in the good not in the good way. So I just delete the opacity map. And as you can see, we cannot see anything because we need to make the texture. So open Substance Painter like this. We can make a texture directly with Paint, but honestly, it's very hard. So go to File, New, 4K, OpenGL, Select, Rear, Add. We're gonna add the Freak, the Color, the Mask, and the Normal. Open, and OK. And now we got our hair. So the first thing we need to do is to go here. Add a channel, Opacity, OK. Go here into this one, Shader Setting. BPR Metal Rug, click on it and choose BP, this one, the you get FX, the golden one, and just after this one, click on it. Okay, now fill, add a fill layer, and inside the fill layer go into texture and base color, choose this one, the color texture we made. Okay, now inside opacity channel, choose the mask. That's it. And inside normal, choose the normal map. And that's it. And now you can zoom inside. As you can see, we got our hair. Maybe the hair we got are too dark. So we can change the dark of the hair. We're gonna change the dark of the air directly inside the character creator free, but here we can change. I think it's pretty nice for air, so I'm gonna keep this. If you want to change the scale of the texture, just unlock here, and this is not the right one, so I keep one. This is the left one, so uncheck this one, uncheck the lock, and you can change the. I will make something bigger, so I go to 0.35. 0.35 seems pretty nice, so I keep 0.35. Okay, it's nice. Maybe my color is a little too dark, so I will change it quickly if I can. So go inside color, go inside modify. I'm directly on paint. And how can I change the color? Maybe. I don't know if I can change the brightness directly inside the paint, so I will open another 2D software. I'm using Clip Studio Paint. So take my color, get inside, that's it, and get inside. Where is it? Filter, no, edition, I think it's this one, more. It works, but I prefer using it directly inside the character creator free, so I don't touch it. So go back to Substance Painter. Okay, the texture is good for me. Go to File, Export Texture. This is 2K, so we choose 2K. I got All, Export. Okay, Open Folder. I got the new texture for my hair, the new sized texture for my hair. So go back inside character creator free, I'm on my hair, and I change Roughness on roughness, metallic on metallic, color on color, opacity on opacity, and default normal OpenGL. This is this one we need to bump. This is a normal map. So, okay. And we got the air. I think the normal map is not good for this one. I will retry. And I say it's a bump map. Yes. Okay, this is not normal map you need to choose. This is bump map. And I got my air, but it's again too dark, so I go inside the base color. Here we are not in white, so I take the white, okay, base color here, adjust, and more, I need something more brightness, maybe 30 seems good, 31, okay, this is better, and I can change the color with the red, the green, the blue, the yellow, all I want, so I will keep, I can make here 0, 0 and 0. You can change the U directly to have a color, maybe something red. Saturation, more color, less color, more color, less color. Okay. So I keep this for this video. So I got this part of the air and new and no with the new air system. When it's done, go inside here, attribute, and choose Preat Air Bronze and Beer. Click on yes, and now you need to choose what part of the air it is. This is a rear part, so rear and apply. That's it. Now you can move your character to check. Okay, the air are moving with the character. Seems nice. I got my rear air part, and if I want to find it, I got inside air, custom, group, air, no, this is not this one, element, air, and where are my air? I don't save it, so I am on it. I just make a quick zoom on it, like this. I am in custom, air part, air, wait, sorry, custom, this is air, and click on plus, and this is here, so rear one, so where it is, let me show, let me find it, go back to the air, group, air, legacy, non, element, air, rear. Okay, that's it. And as you can see, in the left corner of the icon, you get the icon of the rear air. So you know what part of air it is. And that's it. I got all. Now, the only thing I need to do is to create the rest of the air. So I need to create... I need to create now a top, a base, bong, and accessory if I want accessory. That's all.